Hi there, welcome back to Scrap and Coffee. In this video, the last part of the construction for our Christmas trifold mini album. So in this video, I'm going to show you how we construct this middle part, but I want to give you a little heads up because in the video you will see me constructing it with a bigger gusset than it's ending up to be. So I've put the right measurements for the pieces on the bottom of the screen. If they have to change, it's for two pieces that I need to change. So you can see that in the bottom and also in the cutting guide, of course, the right measurements will be there. Also, I want to apologize because in the first part of the construction, you will hear this annoying background sound of when they were removing the snow in front of my house and able to put down some grass. So I'm really sorry about that as well. So let's get to the construction of this middle part. So what's left is the middle part, and I've prepared some pieces already, but I'm going to show you, we're going to make flaps that are going to close in either direction. So you need two of each that I'm showing you, but I've already prepared one side, so I'm going to make one piece of each, but you will need two to make it exactly the same. So I'm going to get this out of my way, and we are going to start with the biggest piece. I have a piece that measures 5.5 by 5.25, and I've made a score line at 1/2 inch and at 7/8 of an inch, so that gives me a 3/8 of an inch gusset. Again, we are going to give this piece a punch at 3 inches with your score lines on the bottom on the 5.5 inch side. I'm going to line it up with 3 inches on my left. So I'm looking at the dented side of my piece, score lines on the bottom, 3/8 of an inch on my left. Punch it, and this I am going to cut away. I'm going to fold on both of the score lines, and then we are going to lay this piece aside for a sec. Then I have a piece that measures, let's start with this one, 5.5 by 4.5, and I've made a score line on the 4.5 inch side at 1/2 inch, and we are going to fold on that one. This will be a flap. And I have a piece that measures, I believe it was 6 inches. Where is my ruler? Where did I leave it? That's funny. Oh, here it is. Yes, 6 inches, and on that side I've scored 1/2 inch and by 5 inches, and on that side I've scored 1/2 inch on both sides, so it's a pocket, but we are going to place it sideways. And also this one needs a punch on the side that has no score line, with the score lines on the sides and the bottom. I'm going to line it up with 1 3/4 on both sides, so one time on the dented side, one time on the bumpy side. And I'm going to cut away that middle piece. I'm going to minor these corners. Fold on this one as well. And now, before I can attach it, I need to give this piece. I'm going to place a piece of patterned paper on here, and I'm going to place a circle on there for an envelope closure. So This piece will go onto this flap. But I'm going to mat it with a piece of pattern paper and prepare it so I can place it on there. So I will do that off camera, and then I'll come back with you to attach it all together. Okay, so I've placed that piece of pattern paper on there, and I've made that little circle with an eyelet that goes on there. And I will show you in a sec what's that going. This is one part of an envelope closure. So we have that flap that we've made, and I really have to think about this one is going in my album in this way. This will be attached to the top, this will be on the bottom. So this will be on the top as well, and about my pocket on my left. So I'm going to place this piece with my half inch flap to the top and line it up. I'm going to remove one side of the tape backing here. And this I'm not going to see anyway, because it's inside the pocket, so I'm not going to worry about it. And otherwise, I really don't mind seeing the side of the eyelet. And just get it on there. And then I'm going to taper these corners of this flap. I've really forgot to taper on several places in this album, and I can see it with my matting, and it's annoying me, but when I'm going to use the album, I probably won't see it anymore. So again, my flaps are on the bottom, and I have to be careful. I have an additional score line here. So I'm going to line it up with that score line that's the second score line. Well, I think I'm going to remove this tape backing partially. And I will line it up with the corner here. And then place it upwards. So I'm still able to see that tab of that piece. So now I have my pocket here, and I will mat the inside of this, but and I have a flap that will open up, and again this will go to the top. So I've already prepared the pieces that will go on the bottom, and this is what we have then. And it will lie in our album like this, and I can use this for a closure to keep it all in place. So this is the exact same piece, only I've directed it the pocket to the other side, and it's opening up to the bottom. And here I used a little magnet to keep that flap in place, and I will do the same thing on that one. And these are really small magnets. I don't recommend you buying them because they're not strong at all. I'm just using them to until they are all finished, so I won't buy them again. The second flap, we have several pieces for that as well. The first piece that we are going to need measures 5.5. And I didn't write it down, but I will measure it for you by 4 3/8. So 5.5 by 4 3/8. And on that 4 3/8 inside, I've made a score mark at 1/2 inch and at 3/4 inch. So that gives us a gusset of 1/4 inch. And we can fold on both of those score lines. Place that to the side for a sec. Then I have a piece that measures 4 inches by 4 1/8 inch, and on the 4-inch side score marks at 1/2 inch on both sides, and 4 1/8 one score mark at 1/2 inch. This is going to be a pocket, but we are going to make a window in it. So I've prepared my pencil. This goes this way. This is what I need to turn around. I made pencil marks on the sides that have a score line at one inch inwards, and on the top where there is no score mark, half an inch inwards. So that gives me a window of a half an inch when we folded everything in. So I'm going to cut on those pencil lines, and normally I would just do it by hand, but I'm a little bit further away now. We'll see how it goes. If you want to use a ruler, you of course use a ruler. And I have one lying right here, but I just feel this goes a little bit quicker. And the pencil marks, I won't be able to see them because this will be the side that that's going to show in the album. So again, with the bumpy side up, I have a piece of acetate that measures 2 5/8 inches by 3 1/4 inches. And I've placed 1/8 inch tape on the perimeter of that piece of acetate. And I can place that right here on that window, on the bumpy side. So this is going to make a really small window. You can place a small picture behind that window, or maybe you cut a part that you cut to size. These are just some fun elements in the album. And they are not particular, well, they are functional, but maybe not as functional as the larger pockets. So I'm going to carefully line it up, give that a burnish so that it gets a really good stick. And then I can minor these corners on the dented side. Or you can do it on the bumpy side as well, it doesn't really matter. It's easier for you. Fold on those. Oh, that's really close, but not overlapping. Okay, I have my piece here again, so I have to be careful because I have that 1/4 inch gusset here, but this will line up with the top. So I can line it up at the top of the piece. I'm not going to make any notch in here because I have the spacing here is just too small. So I'm just going to leave it like this. And then we have a little spacing here left, and we are going to place another small pocket on there. This is a piece that measures 3 1/2 by 3. And on the 3 1/2 inch side, I've made score lines on both sides, and on the 3 inch side on one side. And I am going to give this a punch in the middle of the piece. Again, I'm only doing one punch because it's really small, but I also want to have access to the pocket. So the center of this piece will be 1 3/4. And I'm going to line it up with that 1 3/4. Give it a punch and just have that notch in the middle. We are going to minor on these corners here. A little overlapping. And that's better. And this is just a fun pocket that will hold some tags that you can journal on or something like that. And that will fit right next to this pocket that we've just placed. So here I'm going to line it up with this pocket, and that's score line. And that's pretty hard to see for you, but and it fits on there perfectly. It's always nice when it turns out like that, because sometimes you're just off with your cutting or you're scoring a little bit, and then you have to make a little adjustment. But now it's turning out perfect. And that's the second flap that's going into our album. And I'm going to place this like, oh, and I did it wrong. I will adjust it off camera because I wasn't thinking about it, but this pocket will go to the top. And I don't want my openings here on the bottom. I want them on this side. So I have to turn that around. So I will use my undo and I will place it on the other side so it goes to the top. But I will do that off camera. So I've corrected that top flap. As you can see, well, you're not able to see it right now, but my hinge is on the top. And what I did is I placed it in the, well, I hope I say that correctly, in the counter direction. So I have my window pocket here on the left and on the top one on the right, and the other pocket the other way around. So I thought that was also more fun, a little bit more interest. So I've corrected that, all those flaps already, and we can attach it into our album now. So let's get our album in, go to the middle, and let's, these are my bottom ones. Let's start with those. So I'm going to start with the first one. I'm not going to, am I going to taper these? I'm going to think about it because I think I will place a strip of patterned paper on there. Yes, I'm just going to taper it because I feel like I might regret it if I don't do it. So I'm just going to lay, I'm going to fold on that half inch score line here, so it's, I'm able to see that gusset now, but I'm going to line it up on the bottom. Again, I'm going to use that piece of black cardstock that I've placed here as my guideline. Try to get it straight, of course. So that's the first piece that we have attached. I'm going to open it up. Then the second one will be the one with the two pockets on there, with the window. Again, give it a quick taper. No, I'm off camera for this, but my desk is getting pretty messy. So this one will go, I have that half inch here, and I'm going to line it up with that half inch. And I'm also going to use these lines here as my guide, because I've tapered it up. It's a bit harder to line it up with that half inch, but again, remove that tape backing just a little bit. Line it up. It's a bit hard to see with the black. So now this, with that gusset and with that gusset, that will line up. So now I'm going to turn my book upside down, because it's easier for me to see when I'm working on the bottom. And again, I'm going to start with the first one. Remove this just a little bit. This way. And now it won't completely fit, but that's because I folded on that first half line. My gusset is not standing up, so it will look like it's not going to fit. But I do want the edges to line up as well, so I can use that as my guideline here. give that a burnish. And now when that half inch is standing up, this will meet and it will close almost perfectly. So that's why all the weird measurements of these flaps. Second one. Again, I'm lining it up. Let's remove the tape backing. I can just do that. Don't have to do everything three times. And here I got a little bit damaged with removing the pocket. I wanted to go too fast, but I will cover that up with pattern paper. Again, because I'm folding on a half inch, my gusset is not standing up and it will look like it's not going to fit, but it will be fine when it's standing up. And this will go on top, so that's not a problem. So the flaps are in place now, and I will show you that I ended up with a gusset that's only 1/8 of an inch, and it's pretty hard to see, but it's smaller, and that's because the bulk was just getting too high and the page was really standing up because of that bulk, and I didn't like it and I just wanted to be nice. So that's why I've changed up that gusset over there. So when we open this up, and I made that envelope closure here to keep it all in place, then we have the pocket here on the flap. And it's closing up, and I have to still decorate it. And we have this flap with the two pockets on there. And we have the same thing here on the top. So I placed a little card in there. So now we have this whole open area here. And what I want to do is I want to place one big pocket here with a window where we can put a 6x4 photo underneath. And you can just place your, this is a 6x4. You can just place it like this and then decorate around it with your pattern paper, or place one big piece of pattern paper and then your photo mat on there. But I thought with the window it would give it just a little bit more of a, I'm gonna call it a classy feeling. It kind of gives me a little bit more of a Christmassy album, so I wanted to do something extra for it. So I've prepared a piece for that, so I'm gonna get this out of my way and pay attention. You will get a quick sneak peek of what I've done so far, but I will be quick. So I prepared a piece here that measures, did I put it on there? Yes. 8.25 by 6. And you, if you place your flaps down, you really need to measure if this piece will be the same for you. It should be, but just make sure it really fits between that between the two flaps, and have a little bit of spacing between your folding of the bottom flaps. And then I've made a window on the back. I've prepared it with the pencil marks, and if you do it like this, you will end up with a window that is 6x4, so your picture will fit in there exactly. So what I did is here on the bottoms, I have three score lines here, and on the 8.25 inch side I have one score line, and then I place the pencil mark 1.25 inwards, and on this side I did 3/4 inwards, and on the top and the bottom I have score lines as well, and then I went 1 1/8 inwards for making the window. So I will be cutting that out, and this is a bit of a larger window, so I'm don't think I will be doing it by hand. It's a little bit too tricky, I think. So let's see if this one fits. It does. So I'm going to try to do it a little bit quick, but I also want it to be neat. You know me by now a little bit if you watch my videos. That's why also I had to change it up a little bit with the gussets, because I just wanted to be a good usable album. I'm going to use it myself this year. We are going to spend the holidays with my family, with our family in Europe. So that will be precious to keep that memory keeping for it because our children will be spending some time with their grandparents, and that's kind of precious to us. So I really want to use this album this year. And we are not really used to the Christmas Daily. At least I didn't heard from it until I moved to Canada, actually. So it's not really something that I'm used to doing, but maybe next year I will try it. So now we have the window, and I'm going to keep my opening for the pocket on my right side because I'm right-handed, so it's for me the easiest way to get it out. Then I have a piece of acetate, and let me give you a quick measurement. It's 4 5/8 by 6 5/8, and then I've placed 1/8 inch double-sided tape on the perimeter, and we can place that on the bumpy side on the window that we just got out. One more piece. Oh yeah, that's a Sharpie. Well, I'm not going to see this side, so I'm not going to worry about the pencil marks here. Just make sure you have enough spacing on all four sides. I'm going to give that a quick burnish. Then we can fold on our score lines. So your window around the border around your window is not exactly the same on the top. The top and the bottom is the same and the sides are the same, but the top is not the same as the side. And I did that because I wanted to fit nicely in the space that we have, but I also wanted to be perfect for a 6x4 picture, so that's why it's a little bit different. It doesn't really bother me. If it's bothering you, then you can change that if you want. So I'm going to open all of this up, try to keep it in frame. And now this, I can place that in between these flaps. And I will still have the spacing for getting a picture in there. I just wanted to try it out. Yeah, that will be fine. So I'm going to... let me see, I'm going to remove the tape backing from the bottom. And then I will try to line it up. Try to get an even spacing between my flaps and on my side. And I think this will be okay. So I'm off camera now a little bit, but that's just a little bit too big to keep it all in camera for now. So this is actually optional. You don't really have to do it, but if you like it, then it's a nice option, I think. And we burnish it down. And now we have an opening here on the right, so we can put our picture in there. And that's finalizing the construction for the album, actually. So I'm going to decorate it with pattern paper. I've done a lot already, but still need to do the last part and the embellishments. So when I've done that, I will be back with a final project share, a walkthrough of the complete album. So thank you for watching. I'm sorry that it was a little bit of a, well, the video wasn't the best video, but still I hope it was for you. You were able to follow what I did. And I hope to see you in the project share. So thank you for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day.